Turnier in here. I think it's on. Hello. Turnier in here. I'm playing Total War 1942 for Rome Total War, Barbarian Invasion. The odd thing was that I last played this campaign on March 10, 2020. Then I tried a cool new launcher from Total War in May. It enables the player to, for example, have an AI-only campaign. I recorded one such episode. It went on from 1942 to 1945. Then it crashed. I haven't continued it since then. And anyway, then when I tried to continue the German campaign today, I couldn't load. I were thrown back to the main menu, and it didn't help replacing the folder, etc. But I have like 4 different installation folders for Rome Total War, so I have Rome Total War installed in 4 different locations. And when I tried to move the Total War 1942 folder that was copied in January, I had made a copy back then. When I tried to move it, then it worked. So as you can see, March 10, I couldn't load these saves in the old Rome Total War directory, but now when I moved it to one of the other directories, then it actually started and I could load. So now I can actually continue the campaign. I don't know if it was because of the launching the launcher or not. You know, I haven't used the launcher in the other directories, but if it wasn't the launcher, then I don't know what else could have caused it, because I haven't modified the game. Because I know if I modify the game, I might mess up the campaign. I don't want to do that. So anyway, we can play now. So we are back in the German campaign, and the advance towards the Soviet Union continues. We are counterattacking. They have forced us back. They took back Smolensk, Minsk, Kiev, and they took Riga. But now Riga is in the hands of the rebels, and Rommel here is Erwin Rommel is marching towards Riga with an army. We have other armies marching too. Now I remember when I last played this campaign, I fought the battle of the settlement of Brest, the town of Brest, and we won the battle. Then it crashed, so I need to replay the battle, and if it won't crash, then we will continue. I will actually stop the recording, I guess, and just play it and then start recording after. Alright, see ya. So, I'm back. I just won the Battle of Brest for the second time, and this time it didn't crash. So now we're back in the campaign. I'm playing as Germany in the mod Total War 1942 for Rome Total War or Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion. So we will exterminate the population of Brest, the Poles there, so they won't revolt. Alright, and because we have planes in the army, we will never merge them, but we will merge our infantry, of course. So we have some snipers we can merge here, because if we merge any mechanized units, we will lose too many. It's not worth it, but when it comes to the infantry, it's fine. And possibly cavalry. I mean horse cavalry, not mech cavalry, like planes, BMW motorcycles, jeeps, etc. Alright, and let's merge that unit, yeah. Alright, we have merged the units. And we had another sniper unit here we could merge. Alright, so we have 16 snipers here, and full 40 sized assault infantry units there. Let's merge these two as well. We could disband this unit. We don't need four of them. Alright, and that's the army there. In the city we have another army that we could merge. We will merge the riflemen. One sniper there. We don't need one sniper. Let's disband. And the assault infantry. We have 38 of them there. Let's merge the riflemen first. And 17, we don't really need 17. 27 assault infantry will be merged. 27 assault infantry will be merged with the 38 we had there. 25 is okay, I guess. It's just about half a unit. Alright, and what is this? Resistance is futile in Brest, yeah. We've already done all the moves, I believe, but now we can move this the armies that won outside of Brest, because they hadn't moved anything. So we have three units there of the Soviet Union, three other units over there. Let's see. I think we will... leave four units of riflemen inside of the city and immediately strike at these Soviet troops. What? Half strength? Ah, they have planes. MiG-3 planes. Their best planes. That was not a good surprise. Alright. So we will send some new troops there. Send some planes over there. Of course we will send some planes. We have three slots we can use there. So we have a full army again. See if we can merge any infantry units. 25 units of assault infantry there. Don't really need that truck unit nor the BMW motorcycles, they are too damaged. Send something else. Send the Waffen SS. And let's see here. Another unit of Waffen SS. Let's merge those two. We don't need the... Yeah, 19 is pretty good. It's half a unit. But I think we could do without that one. And then we will send a full unit of snipers instead. And this final unit. These units will move into Brest for now. We'll send out some planes to reinforce the army here. Maybe they could actually attack there. Right, we have four defending Brest. Then we can attack. They have three tank units, but we have planes. Three Messerschmitt 109 fighters and one Stuka bomber, and then we have a sniper unit. So we will fight this battle. On the battlefield. Führer, we are on the march. Victorious Italian troops crossed the Greco-Albanian frontier at dawn today. Benito Mussolini to Adolf Hitler, 28 October 1940. Yeah, that didn't go well for Mussolini. His troops weren't up to the task. They expected World War I, but got World War II. So, let's start the deployment. Should we? Shall we? I like this view too. Alright. With all the planes and stuff. Start the deployment. Alright. So the enemy will probably be towards this side. So this is a hilly battlefield. So let's put the snipers there in loose formation. The planes too can be in loose formation. And then we could start the battle. Now I need to micromanage stuff. So the bombers will attack the first group of tanks. Can send a sniper against them too. Then a second, a fighter unit. Then we can send, wait a second. We'll send the Stuka tactical bombers against the first group of tanks. And this the first group of Messerschmitt 109 fighters will attack the second group of tanks. And then the third group of Messerschmitts will attack the third group. And then we will send another Messerschmitt 109 fighter against the first group. And then the snipers will also attack the first group. Or they could attack the second group, actually. So, start the battle. So the Soviet Union had some, what was their name? Sometimes I can't really remember. MS-1 tanks, alright. So the planes are moving towards their tanks there, the worst type of tank. Should be an easy victory for us, as the tanks are worse than the planes. Cool battlefield, I think. So we are looking at the battlefield from their point of view here. The planes in the sky. They still shot down a few of our fighters there. Our fighters are firing at their tanks too. They are not doing a good job. They are being shot down en masse. It's just kind of sad that the tanks can actually shoot down planes in this game. Alright, so they took out my Stuka bomber. Take out that tank. Shouldn't be too hard. We have taken out most of their tanks, I think. They had some left. There are some tanks still remaining here. And I think we can probably lose if we're unlucky here. Kill that tank. Take it out. Take out the tanks. Alright, we took one out. Now we just need to take out this tank. Man, they did shoot down a lot of our planes. They also have this group here. So it went a lot better for them than I had thought it would. That's because of the hills, I guess. Didn't go well. We could still win, hopefully. Statistics of the battle is that we have lost 49% and they've lost 45%. But we are still leading. And we won. They retreated. But yeah, this was a very bad victory, a Pyrrhic victory, where we lost most of the planes. So we killed 33 tanks and they killed 27 planes, very equal battle. And we have 32 planes remaining, there are 40 tanks remaining, alright. will move. So we are going to move this army towards the other force there. And we will save again. So we don't have to replay anything, because we never know when this game will crash. Alright, and this army maybe could be AI controlled. Fight the battle on the battlefield. They only have planes, their best planes, 3 units of MiG-1s or MiG-9s or whatever. We are now in this war, we are all in it, all the way. Franklin D. Roosevelt, 9th December 1941. So, the battle begins! Start deployment. And I don't think we need to use anything but the planes here. Because everything else, I think, is not a worthy challenge for their planes. We'll move everything else back and then start the battle. And now it's time to manually attack with the planes. So we have we have 6 units of Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes, and we have 3 units of Stuka tactical bombers. Now I just wonder where the enemy planes are. The MiGs, they are here. Alright, so we will three units of fighters could be sent against this unit. It's hard to click on them here because of the hills. Very hard to click on it. Yeah, now I remember, I should click on the shadow, not on the flag. Alright. And then 3 other units against the other 2. And then the final 2 against the 3rd unit. Alright, that's it. So these are the best planes of the Soviet Union, or the United Soviet Socialist Republics, the USSR. So the German planes have reached the Soviet planes, and the dogfighting has begun over these trees here. The dogfighting in the middle of nowhere in the forest. We have clear numerical advantage. And our planes are better than theirs, so we will win this. Of course, their fighters are better than our tactical bombers, but our fighters are better than their fighters. Not much better, but slightly better. So this is a given win. Took down one of their MiGs there. Another one went down. Dogfighting continues in the sky. Let's just fast forward. This was no exciting battle. We will just fast forward everything. Because we had so clear advantage here. Alright, we won. Kills 21. We took down 21 of their planes. They took down 4 of ours. And here's the detailed statistics. Alright. Yeah. hope we can get somewhere now. If we can hopefully advance and take back the regions we lost, so we can start to, you know, advance in the campaign and not just be forced back all the time. Because it feels like we haven't gone anywhere but backwards as of yet. Can't move that unit anymore. The plane can be moved. This army could move up. Keep that plane there in case they are attacked. Planes are good. Alright, the rest of the units or armies have already done their moves this time. We are already building. Alright, currently we have 16 regions controlled. We started with like 28, so we have lost a lot of regions. We have also abandoned the regions in Africa and in Greece and in the Balkans to be able to focus the entire front on the Soviet Union. Alright, we have a spy here, female spy. We can look into this city and see Nikolai Ivanov. He has two MiG-3s. They were MiG-3s, not MiG-1s or MiG-9s, but MiG-3s, alright. MMS-1s. Alright. But even with their best planes, they still don't really match ours. Ours have 8 melee attack, 40 missile attack, and 35 defense. Well, their plane has 3 melee attack, 33 missile attack, and 29 defense. Also, mine might be higher experience, yeah. They are experience 8 and 5 and 4. 2, for example, had the way worse stats, for example 34 missile and 30 defense. Yeah, they do level up if you win battles, so that's why they are so high level. Yeah. Alright, it's time to click end turn. So the Soviet Union did attack us. They attacked with their general Grigory Petro. He has 528 men. Let's take a look where he is on the map. So he is here on the battlefield, close to Minsk. I had an army deep inside of their territory, Walter Graf, with 369 men, with some Vesp artillery, some Panzer I tanks, some Panzer IV tanks, and some planes, and some infantry, and the BMW motorcycle unit. His unit is mostly consisting of the tanks, T-34 tanks, their medium tanks, and one unit of MS-1 light tanks. They have an assault infantry unit, a rifleman unit, and a Katyusha unit. And they have two generals bodyguard, but it's just a rifleman bodyguard, one of them, Vladimir Petro, and the other one, it's probably the same, yeah. So they are starting generals and starting armies. Let's save the game before starting the battle, and then we will fight the battle on the battlefield. I need to save before in case it crashes after the battle or before the battle, because then I can just load it up and continue. Otherwise I need to, you know, redo a lot of stuff. Fight battle on the battle map. Yes, it's most likely to crash after a battle. But it usually don't happen. It will happen sometimes. Usually when there are like an numerical advantage for the enemy and I still win. But usually it won't crash the second battle I fight. So if it does crash, then I will just need to replay it and then it won't crash. Alright, fight the battle on the battle map. So the battle begins. Zooming in the army, let's start the deployment. All right, the infantry in one army. Bit loose formation. We will have the tanks and planes in different groups. The planes will be one group. We only had 6 units of Messerschmitt 109 fighters here. And the tanks, all the tanks will be one group. Panzer battalions, because German word for tank is panzer. So we have 2 Vesp artillery units. They will be on loose formation and with the fire at will function active. This seems to be a hilly battlefield, so I think we will simply place the artillery somewhere like this if we can place them. Yeah, we will place them here so they can have a clear shot at the enemy. So this is the Vesp artillery. Unfortunately, in Room to the War, they are just like ordinary artillery, so they have crews. That means you don't need to destroy the artillery piece, but if you drive over the men, they can't use it, so they are kind of weaker than in real life. Well, the tanks, they are cavalry, so they can be alone. Alright, and as for the BMW motorcycles, they still don't have crews, so I hope they will die pretty soon after the battle starts. So the general's bodyguard could be in the back. He has a jeep bodyguard. Alright, we have another artillery unit here, could also be placed here. Fire at will on. Fire at will mode on. Alright, start the battle. And now we just need to micromanage. So we will of course send the planes against these deadly trucks here. Send two fighter units against them. Then against their worst tank, we are going to send one Panzer I unit. Actually, we can send 2 against them, but I won't do that because they have too many tanks. We'll send one against this, even though it's at a disadvantage because it's a Panzer I. We send a Panzer IV against that unit, and then another Panzer IV against this one. Of course, the motorcycles could attack their infantry. The artillery will just fire randomly at the enemy. And then we will attack the planes here against their other tanks. They will hopefully be blitzed. So we have attacked with all of them now. As for the snipers, could attack the last tank group. And then the infantry will of course focus on their infantry. Riflemen against riflemen there. SS against that unit in the back, the bodyguard. And that's it. Let's start the game. They are moving forward. There are tanks here across the entire front. Huge line of tanks. Our BMW motorcycles are now closing in on them. They were not that far away. I placed them pretty close to them. Then our planes arrive. They are firing from their Katyushas there. I'm sure the name is Katyusha. Katyusha, yes. They are really dangerous. Their worst unit. We have some Panzer IVs in this battle. And Panzer I's. So it's become a mess already. The There is a dogfight going on in the air, in the sky. Our tanks are now arriving. Here are the Soviet tanks and the infantry. So my tanks are a little behind here. Our infantry are moving up to face their stuff, their infantry. They are marching on here, onwards towards the enemy. The tanks are firing while standing still. Give them some boost in morale there, the general. We have the Vesp artillery firing their projectiles. It wasn't the best battlefield for artillery with all the hills. But it will have to do. So this Vesp unit will fire there. I wonder if they hit anything or if the hills protect the Soviets. So we have killed a lot of their infantry already. And their tanks. Panzer IVs are now moving onwards. Hunting their units there. Probably their tanks are retreating or something. We have some T-34s here. But they seem to be at a withdrawal. They've lost most of their units. So the balance of power is clearly at our advantage. Percentage enemies killed 68% and we have only lost 13%. Vladimir Petrov has also fallen, one of their two generals. Yeah, they are defeated. Their second general, Grigory Petrov, has fallen in battle. And our troops are marching onwards, while their troops are retreating. The white flag there. Continue the battle. Kill as many as possible so they don't have troops left. We need to reach 85%. Otherwise some of their troops will survive the battle. And continue another day. If we kill more than 85%, they will all be dead. So, and it's over. But I think we failed in that mission. We killed 84%. Alright, clear victory. Walter Graf. Men deployed 369 men, killed 443, very good. Men remaining 340. And men deployed of Grigorio Petrov, he had 528 men, killed 47, 81 remaining. That's because we had lot of planes and he had mostly tanks. So that's why. Your task will not be an easy one. Your enemy is well trained, well equipped and battle hardened. He'll fight savagely. General Dwight D. Eisenhower, 6 June 1944. Didn't crash, very good. So our turn again. End of turn report. We are minus 155 in profits, but we still do not have a minus on the map, so it's fine. Recruitment report. So we recruited in Berlin, we have a new Panzer IV constructed. In Frankfurt we also have a Panzer IV. In Vienna we have assault infantry recruited. In München we have built another Panzer IV. In Hamburg a Panzer I. In Copenhagen we have assault infantry. In Oslo we have assault infantry. In Rouen we have Stuka tactical bombers. In Amsterdam we have Stuka strategic bombers. In Paris we have Stokes mortar artillery. In Brussels we have some Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. In Prague we have some Panzer IVs constructed. In Bordeaux we have Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. In Warsaw we have Stuka tactical bombers. And in Stettin we have a new Panzer IV. Alright, and then diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. the League of Nations that have and the French Republic and the United States of America, they have declared war on India, a former ally of theirs. The French Republic is the Free French as well, the rebels, they are not the French state. The following factions have declared they are allies: People's Republic of China and the Chinese Republic. So the People's Republic of China is Communist China, and Chinese Republic is the government that ruled China back in the 40s and 30s, and they are the government of Taiwan today. The following factions have declared a ceasefire: USSR, or the United Soviet Socialist Republics, or the Soviet Union, as they are commonly known as, have declared a ceasefire with Hungary. What? So Hungary has declared a ceasefire with the Soviet Union. Alright. So we have an army here. Should never merge tanks and other mechanized units. But we can merge infantry. Alright, we only had one infantry unit that we could merge. So we have an army there. This army will of course move up towards that army. Face it head on. So they have 6 units of MiG-3 fighters, and then they have just some infantry. But their planes are still dangerous. I still think we can win that battle. Then we have an army here with mostly infantry. So we'll march it onwards. Let's move towards this city. Kiev. We want to take back Kiev. And we have an army here, but it's just a remnant force. Let's move a unit of infantry there. And move this unit up as well. We will move the plane unit to that army. And move this army back to Brest. That sucked, you should have moved one of the infantry units there. Let's move a plane unit to Brest as well. We might need it when we defend there. So we have the general Fred Hoblen in Brest, a Polish town. And we have the general Felix Battle marching towards Kiev. And the general Gottfried Gehlen is also marching towards Kiev, while the general Walter Graf is marching towards this army. Actually, I will probably move this army around and attack Minsk the next turn. Or maybe not. I will attack Minsk with this army and Gunther Alterbung. This time we will attack Kiev. Both of them can attack Kiev together. And Rommel, he has a good army. with mostly tanks. I don't like wasting it on a city with big defenses, the East Wall. Would probably force them to sally out. How long can it? 7 turns, but that's a lot of turns. We might ignore Riga actually and just move Rommel towards Leningrad. Alright, we've moved enough with those units. Let's see what we can build and recruit. We will also need to move the fleet. So we have the fleet over here. We have a British Navy. So we have some troopers. I don't think the U-boats can fight that. You could see. They could, but they are at a great disadvantage. We'll try to sink their fleet here. Clear defeat. They were defeated. We only have 5 U-boats left. That was a big defeat. They can still be used to transport ships, but I guess they have lost their naval strength. Have another fleet here. The remnants of the two other fleets that we had at the start. Alright, then we have a diplomat. We can speak to the Soviet Union. Click on the listed offer and see if they have any new map information. And we will give them ours as well. 1940, they knew everything about the world. So. Makes sense they have their map informations. Alright, and where can we find the rest of our agents? We need to look up where the others are. This is probably the same. Felix von Kutchler is outside of Helsinki, occupied the Finnish capital. Then we have Ferdinand outside of Bucharest, in control by Romania. We have a Turkish army here too. So I think we will speak to Romania now.
Left-click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Map information.
A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be.
They could also be forced into an alliance. And they should attack the Soviet Union. And that's it. So Romania still has three regions there. Italian Empire, let's speak to them as well.
Left click on the list.
Now when they were close to the diplomat.
Left click on an item in the proposal.
Good thing with Rome to the War is that you can talk with as many as you want each turn, as long as you have neighbors close by. In Medieval 2 you need to wait the turn before they can speak to another faction. And that is, it's a bad decision that they remove the possibility to, you know, talk with as many as you want. Alright, map information. Italy, so their updated map is now visible. So Turkey has conquered Tirana from Italy. So Italy has lost Tirana to Turkey. I gave Crete and Athens to Turkey when I decided to move my troops towards the east. And then Turkey attacked Italy and took an area there. United States have taken my area, Tunisia, after I left it to the Italians. And the British have taken Benghazi from the Italians after I gave it to them. But they still hold this area, Tripoli. Alright. So Tunis is the capital of Tunisia, I guess. And Tripoli is capital of Libya, and Benghazi was the biggest city in Libya. Right, so the Allies have won in Africa pretty much. Italy is not entirely beaten, but almost. They hold some areas in Africa still, and they are holding their starting areas in Italy and Zagreb that I gave to them. And I moved my army. But they have lost Tirana that they started with. Alright. Let's speak to Turkey as well. Because they were neutral in history, I can't do more than give them map information and ask for map information. But that's fine. Now we got some new stuff. They have taken an area in the in mainland Italy as well. They've gone and taken Palermo from Italy. So they have actually built boats and taken it. Even though the smaller factions in this game can only have very bad troopers. So they don't have a great fleet. They would have no chance against the Italian fleet. They somehow managed to send troops here and take Palermo. Turkey is pretty big. They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 regions. So they would become a stronger, smaller power. They had 4 regions from the start, I believe. All in this area, these 4. Now they have twice as many. After they have beaten back the Italians here. They are doing what Greece did. And I'm not helping the Italians. Alright, let's see if we can speak to Bulgaria as well.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create
map information, of course.
In the proposal to remove it. A ballot.
Map information. Bulgaria is holding Sofia and Saloniki. Their starting areas. They also hold Belgrade, the capital of Yugoslavia or Serbia in today's world. That I gave it to them. They are also holding Novi Sad. They might have taken from Hungary. Let's move the diplomat towards Hungary. We have a USSR diplomat there. So we have an alliance now with Romania. It had been broken for some reason. And we have Alfred von Katchler in Spain, another diplomat. Speak to Spain again.
Left click on the listed offer and demand
items. They were also neutral. Sent a legion to Germany during the war against the Soviet Union. So we have Spain's updated information, and we could also use Portugal's. They were also neutral. An allied faction even took their dictatorship. So this is the new information. We got some areas here because Portugal had some map information here. They own a region here. The city Macau. They're surrounded by Japanese and Chinese there. They also used to have a region here, but they have lost it probably. And some areas over here. And some areas in Africa, but they have lost them too. No, they still have them. They have this area here. Large town, Luanda. And some areas over here. Town, Beira. Yeah, so they have 2 areas in Africa. They might have had some ISIL tune somewhere. Anyway, so our U-boat fleet got defeated and had to retreat. We have moved our troops this time. It's time to see if we can build anything. Started buildings. In Berlin we are constructing a heavy tank factory. Hamburg we can't build anything. Same in Oslo, München, in Frankfurt we are building large caserne. In Amsterdam we are also building a large caserne, I believe. And in Brussels we have a mortar training ground being constructed. And in Paris we have a big caserne being constructed. And in Rouen we have a medium caserne that they are constructing. Bordax, we have the small caserne being constructed. Brest, we can't build anything. In Warsaw, we are building the small caserne. In Vienna, we can't build anything. In Prague, we can't build anything. In Stettin, we can't build anything. In Copenhagen, we can't build anything. We're back in Berlin. Now let's take a look at the units. So in Berlin, we can recruit or build all these units. And we did construct the Panzer IV. I still need to move the units we constructed in the settlements, I see. Alright, I want the tank army, so we will of course build another Panzer IV in Berlin. In Hamburg we will build another Panzer I. And in Oslo a unit of assault infantry will be recruited. In München we could build another Panzer IV. Frankfurt, another Panzer IV. In Amsterdam, we could not build any tanks. We will actually construct some Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. And in Bristol, we could make or construct a Panzer I. In Paris, we will actually construct a Stuka tactical bomber. In Rouen, we will build some Panzer I tanks. In Bordeaux, we'll get some Panzer I tanks. And in Warsaw, we'll get some Panzer I tanks as well. In Vienna, we could recruit some assault infantry. In Prague, we could construct a Panzer IV tank or Panzer. In Stettin, we will get a Panzer IV. In Copenhagen, we will get another assault infantry. We're back in Berlin. Alright, now it's time to move the troops we have actually constructed. Let's take a look at our regions. We have Brest here. They will just defend. Then we have Warsaw. We could defend there as well, but we should move one general out. He could move back to another place. We have a general here in Vienna already with an infantry army. We have no general in Prague, so we could move this guy to Prague. And then in Stettin we have a tank. We'll move the tank up towards Brest. Panzer IV. And in Berlin we should have another Panzer IV that will move up towards Warsaw. Hamburg, we have both planes and tanks, but I will keep some planes there for defense. We'll move the Panzer I tank towards the front. In Frankfurt, we have the Panzer IV, so we will move it. And in München, we will also move a Panzer IV and a Stuka tactical bomber. We can move both. Move the same distance. Alright, so tanks and planes can move the same distance in this game. And in Bristol we could move actually both the BMW motorcycles and the Panzer I tanks. We will keep the planes there. Oh, they had three planes. We could move one of them towards the front. They have three, we will move on. Paris, we had some stuff we could move. I'd like to move the tanks. One unit of artillery could be moved as well. Move this towards Berlin. So here we had another unit of tanks and planes. They will also move towards München there. Keep two planes there. And in Bordeaux we have a new tank unit. Can move two planes as well. So we're done with moving the units. Alright, we could have some battles to fight, I believe only one actually. This army could fight that army. Alright, we are at a disadvantage, but they will still attack. Army will still march on, even if we lose. So their army has 6 units of MiG-3s. And they have 6 units of riflemen and 1 unit of snipers. And we have a lot of stuff, varied stuff. Alright. Don't know if I just saved. 18. I don't know, but to be safe, I will save again. Alright, start the battle. We could do with some of those razor blades, Herr Reich Marshal, Field Marshal Erwin Rommel. razor blades. Reich Marshal, that's probably Hermann Göring. Alright, so we'll start the deployment soon. Battle is about to begin. We are at a disadvantage, but we have a lot of planes. We might win this if we're lucky here. We're gonna march onwards no matter what, and let's group our units, the infantry into one group, tanks into second group. We had a lot of tanks in this army, and then we have some planes and our artillery. Right, and then we had some artillery, yes. And the artillery will be set on fire at will. BMW motorcycle isn't an artillery unit. Alright, and then the general could be moved back. Alright, start the battle. And let's order the units individually. So, I guess we will send a fighter plane unit against this unit here. Another one against this. And another one here. And another one there. We had a bomber team. We had one less plane unit. They had one more plane units than we had. They had six plane units, we had five. And one of ours are not even fighters. So the Stuka tactical bombers are at a disadvantage. That means we have four better planes against their versus six units of planes. Our BMW motorcycles will attack their snipers there. Actually, I will probably order my snipers to take care of their snipers. And the BMW motorcycles could be ordered to attack one of their riflemen units instead. The Stokes mortar will fire at will, and then we have our infantry. We could attack this unit with an SS unit there, and then this rifleman unit will attack that rifleman unit, and this one will attack this unit. And that's all our infantry. Now we have the tanks. We have two artillery units here. I didn't see that they were artillery in time. Let's place them at fire to wheel mode. And then our light tanks. They will... let's see what we can attack. They have no tanks in this battle. And I don't really remember if we attacked all of them. Anyway, we will send tanks against their planes then. So, that's it. Let's start the battle. So these are the MiG-3s of the Soviet Union. Our planes are already arriving to the front. The tanks coming behind. Panzer 1s, Panzer 4s. The infantry coming last. And the artillery all the way over here firing it. Supposed to fire. Maybe they are too far away. Anyway, let's go back to the front lines here. The Panzer IVs moving forward towards the enemy. Some of my Panzer Ones have already been taken out. There's a dogfight in the sky. The this will be an equal battle because they have the advantage in planes, the best unit of the game. They also had an advantage in infantry. Their infantry are more numerous than us too. So one unit of Soviet infantry is like 180 men, while or at least twice as many as the German infantry. And they have the same stats otherwise. Some tanks here running around fighting their planes as well, which isn't very historically accurate, but that's how it is in this game. Tanks can fire at planes too. Everyone can fire at planes. But it's very hard for infantry to shoot them down. Our tanks are moving forward here. Are already moving down their infantry and chasing them. Still have planes in the air too. That's why they can still win. Their infantry is retreating. That's not unexpected. Infantry is the worst type of unit you can have in an army. The airplanes are doing good, taking out some of my tanks, including some Panzer IVs. The reason I'm constructing tanks and not planes is because I wanted to be more close to history, so I want Germany to have Panzer armies to face the remaining Soviet tanks. It's too easy with planes, so I felt it's better to focus on tanks and infantry and artillery and then planes last. I do it to increase the difficulty of the campaign and to be more close to history. The reason I spammed constructing planes for a while was because I thought I would be defeated, because my armies were defeated, my starting armies in the east, and the other armies were far away in Africa and Greece and the Balkans. I weren't sure I would reach the front in time, but now I have reached the front, so I don't need planes for now. It's too easy with planes. I want the AI to be able to start building planes too, you know. They started with lots of tank armies, and I can easily win against them with planes. So I want it to be a more of a challenge. I will construct panzers, but when the AI start to construct planes and mass, I will of course return to constructing planes. Then it will be more of a plane versus plane situation. You see, they have already started to build planes. They had 6 units of their best planes in this battle. Planes that weren't available in the beginning of the campaign. But, it will be a while until they start focusing mostly on planes. When that happens, of course, I will need to change to planes. Otherwise, I will be steamrolled. So the dogfight in the air, in the sky, continues. Some of my panzers are safe from behind. Not doing much. The balance of forces is evenly matched. 16% of my troops have been killed, 43% of their troops. Not their tanks. Let's fast forward. So it will be a little faster with this dogfight. Very equal battle in the air. My planes are stronger, they had more. Very equal battle in the air, in the sky. We might lose. In the balance of power, we are exactly at the middle. I think we are going forward now. Might change though. the sky battles could take forever if we don't use the fast forward button. So that's why we do that. This was very equal. Very equal battle in the sky. And they are still not defeated. Shit, they are starting to win this. I need to slow down my stuff. Seems they will win the battle in the sky. And if they do that, they might actually win the battle. So the planes are really dangerous. The one that has air superiority will win. The SS infantry is still firing their assault rifles here. There's some tanks in behind as well. We'll probably try to move them up. Let's pause the game. We'll try to use the tanks against those guys. Let's use the artillery as well. The infantry could actually attack their planes. And that's it, I believe. Let's start the battle again. Continue the battle. All the remaining troops have been ordered to attack their planes. Even the tanks. Sacrificing everything there. Panzer I will probably be shot down though, yeah. We had clear air superiority here. We took down some of their planes, most of them. Some snipers over here. That will be an easy match for the planes too. The Stokes mortar. And the Vesp artillery. Come on, soldiers, take down those planes. Hope you will manage to do so. They have started to fire now. The planes are now counter-attacking against the snipers and the artillery. Probably shooting at the snipers now. Yeah. The artillery is counter-attacking. They're onslaught here. They defeated my planes. Look at this battlefield. They won the battle in the sky. But it was very equal. Problem is they have crews. So when they rout, we will lose. So I think we have lost this. The general will have to retreat. Forgot to move him. I don't want to risk my general. The planes have a very long range, so he might be defeated. There is the general himself. Hope he will be able to leave the battlefield. Yes, he managed to survive. Soviets won this battle, yeah. So, Walter Graf had 344 men, and he killed 299, that was pretty good. He has 28 remaining. And enemy army under Captain Yevgemy had 649 men, twice as many, and they killed 294, so almost the same kills. They have 355 remaining. So they won due to their numerical advantage in mostly planes. Here's the detailed statistics. And let's continue and hope it won't crash. The fruits of victory are tumbling into our mouths too quickly. Emperor Hirohito of Japan, 29th April 1942. Yes, didn't crash. So we lost the one battle that we could fight this time. We attacked the army here and we lost. We have one less army. We are far from defeated. We have a plain infantry army there. Another plain infantry army. And here we have an army of mostly infantry, but with some planes and artillery. There's a remnant army. Walter Graf survived. Let's see. We don't need 3 units of artillery or 5 units of riflemen. Let's disband them. But we will try to save Walter Graf. Here we had another general with mostly infantry, some planes and some artillery. Then we have the best army, the army of Erwin Rommel. It might not be the best because they don't have that many planes, but they only had fighter planes, but they have a lot of tanks and BMW motorcycles and artillery, and also some really cool North Africa assault corps, only recruitable in Africa, that are better than the ordinary assault corps, but worse than the SS. Infantry. Alright, so we will click next turn. They attacked one of our armies. We seem to have the upper hand. They have 2 armies too. One of their armies consists of fighter planes, 1 Jak 9 full sized plane unit, and 2 MiG 3s. We have 1, 2, 3 units of fighter planes against their 3. Then we have at least 4 units of Stuka bombers. Then we have infantry. They have 2 additional fighter plane units here. That means they have an advantage in the sky because their 5 fighter planes trumps our 3 fighters and 4 bombers, because bombers are really bad against fighters. Then they have 2 artillery units as well. They might win this battle. We are going to fight it and try to win it. So General Felix Battle is attacked in the area of, in the region of Kiev, where he entered during the last turn. So let's fight the battle on the battle map. Boys, if you ever pray for me now. Harry S. Truman, 13th April, 1945. Start deployment. Infantry in 1 unit. They are pretty much worthless, they will be slaughtered. All my hope is on the actual planes to do their job here. We will put them in loose formation, and the infantry will also be in loose formation. We will place the general himself in loose formation as well and move him back. I don't want to lose him the first thing that happens in the battle. Let's move him even further back and start the battle, pause the game, and give out individual orders. They have 2 armies. 2 smaller armies. So this army is the one that we are consisting of mostly planes and a general unit. It's a great general, the one with the jeep bodyguard. No, this also had the mortar. This is the unit with just one plane unit. I believe this army over here has only planes, yes. 3 units of MiG, 2 units of MiG 3s and 1 Jak 9 fighter. Alright, so we will focus on one army at a time. the infantry could attack their artillery unit there. And then we will send the fighter plane against their fighter plane. And the bombers could attack their jeep bodyguard. Could also attack their Stokes mortar. And that's it.
Der Feind bringt Verstärkung!
Just need their other planes to enter before we send them in. My Stuka squadrons have already reached the enemy. They're dropping bombs now on their jeeps and Stuka and the mortars here. Good job. Looking good. Let's pause the game because their other fighter planes have entered the area where I can click on them. So we have another fighter plane unit here. They will of course attack immediately. The Yak-9s are worse than the MiG-3s, and the MiG-3s are worse than our planes. So our fighters are better than both their planes. Right. So we're done. We sent some planes to take care of their reinforcements there. They are on their way to meet their planes. We'll dogfight there in the beast, while the rest of the army will fight this army. Seems their rifleman unit here is already broken. Our bombers are dropping bombs on them. So their ground forces are crushed. I don't know about the jeep bodyguard, but the artillery is crushed. Stokes mortars. Seems the jeeps are also crushed. Unless they've escaped. They had some planes here, but they are fighting a unit of our planes, if I'm not mistaken. We have our other planes. Here's one unit. Then we have the dogfight over here. Trees make it kinda odd when they move around. They are in the way somehow. That's why it looks so odd, like a stop in the middle of their flying. Alright, Stokes mortar artillery retreating there.
Dank sei Gott! Unsere Männer haben den feindlichen General erschlagen.
The general is dead. Captain Boris is just a captain, I see. Captain that led the three plane units. That means one of their planes got taken out. Assault artillery infantry firing something there. More assault infantry here. So we had half the unit being assault infantry and the other half being riflemen. I'm just a little worried that they will shoot down my tactical bombers with their fighters. If my fighters weren't strong enough to take care of them there. Most of my fighters went to fight with these guys. They were sent here, most of them. I think we will win this battle. 4% allies killed. 60% enemies killed. they've started to bring more planes to the battles. But it wasn't enough to handle my planes here. I had enough planes. Despite deleting half my army of two of my new armies in a prior episode. When I merged the units, they were kind of deleted half of the tanks and half of the planes. Panzers, not tanks. Let's fast forward the air battle. So, the battle is almost over, and we managed to win, continue the battle, to kill as many of them as we can. 68% killed, currently, 5% of our allies killed, or our troops. So 68% of the enemy is now killed. I think we won now. Alright, so Felix Battle had 904 men, killed 241. That wasn't that great, but as it were mostly planes, I think it was okay. Men remaining 863, so most survived the battle. Enemy armies, Captain Boris, had 73 men, killed 3, that was really bad of him. Have 55 remaining, so that wasn't good. Pavel Vasilevsky had 281 men, killed 45, and had 49 left. Right, and the detailed screen here, and the battle is over. The Germans may claim with some justification to have won, if not a victory, at least an important success over us. General Alexander, September 1943. It didn't crash, good. We'll play until it CTDs, then I will continue some other time. We'll try to upload a new episode every day from Lord of the Rings Total War and this mod. And maybe some Medieval 2 mods, Hyrule Total War, Third Age Total War, or something else. Construction report. Bordax, small caserne. We have built a small caserne in Bordax and in Warsaw. Nice. So we can make basic assault infantry there. Or at least ordinary infantry. Recruitment report. In Vienna we have assault infantry. In Copenhagen we also have assault infantry. And in Oslo, alright. So there are 3 new units of assault infantry in those cities. And it's a new turn. We are still on the year 1942. This army will now reach Kiev. And start besieging it. Maintain siege, we don't have any artillery units, we can't attack this time. Have an army here. We could attack the army. Or we could help with the siege. Let's see here. Let's move Rommel towards Leningrad. Well, this general will retreat. And this army could now attack Minsk, which it will do. Could attack due to the mortars, but I want to have a ram, possibly. What kind of city is this? It has the east wall. Then we could probably attack. But I kind of want to let the AI control them. We will attack the next turn. They don't attack us. Alright, and tanks here to move into the city. The 2 Panzer IVs moving in there. 1 Panzer I there. War, so... This general reached Prague. Some more mechanized units moving towards the front there. Even more of them. Some more mechanized stuff moving up towards the front. Some French units on our lands. Actually, Vichy France should be a vassal, not an ally. But as long as they don't betray me, they will be an ally, otherwise we'll make them a vassal. They were a vassal historically. But you can't start with vassals in this game. I could use total diplomacy to force them to be a vassal too. Like I did in Lord of the Rings for the goblins, because they betrayed me all the time. They are less likely to betray you if they are a vassal or protectorate. As compared to an ally, they might betray you all the time in this game if they are an ally. They are not to be trusted. We have a Soviet fleet here. We'll take care of it immediately. So, ships deployed 15. Ships sunk 0. Ships remaining 15. So they killed one of our, but we still won that battle. Good that we won the battle. Let's move it back to the port there, of Berlin, or Stettin. So we have plane unit in Vienna, Panzer IV in Prague, I want to move that. Stettin only had one unit of infantry, that's not a lot. Move some units out of there. Alright, Minsk, we have two units of planes, I can keep them. Yeah, nothing to move in most other areas. So, in Paris, maybe we could move an artillery unit there. And the BMW motorcycle unit could be moved here from Bordeaux. We had a U-boat fleet that could be moved towards Germany. Right, time to recruit. So, we are still constructing the heavy tank factory in Berlin. Alright. Frankfurt, we are constructing the large caserne. It will be finished the next turn. Amsterdam, we are also doing a large caserne. Bristol, we are constructing a mortar training ground that will be finished the next turn. Alright. Products, we can build something new. I will go for the medium caserne. And in Warsaw, there are some civil buildings we could build as well. I will go for the medium caserne. It will enable us to build scout snipers as well. I believe we can recruit riflemen and assault infantry. Also, we have Panzer Ones there too. Alright. Medium caserne. Now the units. In Oslo, we'll go for another unit of assault infantry. And in Vienna, we'll also recruit another unit of assault infantry. Same in Copenhagen, capital of Denmark. And that's it. I don't know if we could move any troops. Yeah, this unit could move. I will move the agents now. agent. So we have a spy here, the female spy. I won't move her, I like that I can see that stuff. Felix von Katchler. Felix von Katchler. He can't do anything this time, I don't think the map has changed a lot. Ferdinand von Katchler could reach Hungary actually. We need to have their updated map information. And we could use some alliance with them. They broke off the alliance previously. We are allied with them again as well. And they have two areas here. Full army in Uzhgorod and a smaller army in Budapest, including Messerschmitt 109 planes, same as our fighter planes. They've lost all the areas here since long ago. Alliance announced, the Third Reich in Hungary. Ceasefire in effect, Hungary and Bulgaria. Ceasefire in effect, Hungary and Romania, yeah, our alliance broke the war between them. Maybe they will declare war on each other again, I don't know. Alright. So we can't attack the cities this time. We can move the diplomats, maybe. That's an Italian Empire diplomat, that's Portugal, Bulgaria. Shame I don't have British or something here. USSR, Hungary. Let's just move him down. French state, which I already have all their map information. Here we have Italian Empire, the Third Reich, Italian Empire. Yeah, I know what I should have done. Move the diplomat to Africa. Portugal. I need to send a fleet here. Alright, and now as for the battles. Could attack this unit here. They fled. Retreated. So I don't know. Move this army up towards the city instead. And next turn. So they did attack. They combine some of their troops too. Here they have 107 men. Can't look at it. Then they have Ivan Kudyakov. Ivan Kudyakov. With this army, mostly infantry, some good fighter planes, 4 units of MiG-3s and 1 unit of Yak-9s. And 1 MS-1 tank and 1 T-34 tank. Right, it's not that bad. Let's see if he has an armored officer's car as well as a bodyguard. Pretty good strength. Then he has planes, I believe, inside of the city. And we are going to fight the battle, even if we lose the battle. Our army is mostly infantry, but we have a jeep bodyguard and we have 1, 2, 3, 4 units of Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes and 3 units of Stuka tactical bombers. Let's start the battle. Fate of the Empire rests on this enterprise. Every man must devote himself totally to the task in hand. Admiral Isoroku Yamamoto, Commander-in-Chief of the Japanese Navy, 7th December 1941. We have some farms here. Start deployment. All the infantry units. units will be loose formation and one group. All the planes will be loose formation and one group. Alright, so this was a mix of the best units, the planes, and the worst units, the infantry. Start the battle and let's individually order the troops around. You can start with the rifleman, etc. One rifleman unit will attack that rifleman unit. Another one will attack that one. And then the third will attack their third unit of riflemen. And the fourth unit of riflemen will attack their fourth unit of riflemen. There they have an assault infantry unit. Oh, I managed to attack with that. Let's remake it. So, this first unit of riflemen will attack their first unit of riflemen. Our second unit of riflemen will attack their second unit of riflemen. Our third unit of riflemen will attack their third unit of riflemen. And the fourth unit of riflemen will attack their fourth unit of riflemen. Our assault infantry unit here will attack their assault infantry. We have another fifth unit of riflemen there that we will attack with riflemen. Their sixth unit of riflemen will face our sixth unit of riflemen. And they have a seventh unit of riflemen, and we are forced to use assault infantry against them. And then their eighth unit of riflemen will face a unit of assault infantry. And that's all their infantry. And then I think we go for the fighter planes. A MiG 3 there will face our Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Another unit there. A little more there. We have some Stukas too. We will be forced to attack fighters. Which isn't good. We will send a Stuka bomber against their tank unit, the T-34 tank. And another Stuka against their unit of MS-1 tanks, wherever it is. I believe I saw one of those too. Yes. And then the last one will face their planes as well. Our general could attack the air general, I believe. We'll probably lose the general. Maybe he won't be moving from the start of the battle. Let's start the game. Because they have a huge second army arriving here with lots of more planes. I think they might win this battle. Our planes are better than theirs, but they have so many more that they might win. Half our army was infantry, even though we had some assault infantry too. Forward soldiers, fight the last man. This is a very, very dangerous battle. It looks on the ground. The Stukas bombing them. The fighters fighting in the air or above them. A general's dead. Enemy general fallen. Ivan Kudyako is dead. One of our units are routing here. So the infantry. Yeah, this battle was hard. Zoom in on the minimap there. Troops are moving forward. Let's blow the horn there for the general. Two of our assault infantry units are retreating already. Another one, three of them. They had a numerical advantage in planes and in infantry and tanks. No, I don't think they had more tanks than us. We had no tanks, but yeah, we had more infantry than they had, but that doesn't really count. So what's the statistics? Balance of forces evenly matched, percentage enemies killed 38%, percentage allies killed 28%. So we are leading in the percentage statistics, but the meter is on their side, so I believe we will lose. I need to check where my general is currently. Let's move him back. They don't have a lot of health, the generals. The jeeps have normal health now, like the BMW motorcycles. They aren't overpowered. It's usually the siege battles that will crash. So if I win a battle in a city, it might crash and then I need to replay it. Could crash on the battlefield as well, but that's not as common, especially not when I use planes. If I win superior victories, if I win with the odds heavily on my side, it won't crash. It's usually when they lose and they have the upper hand in the statistics, that's when it might crash. So they are sending in some scout snipers against our jeep bodyguard. Let's fire at them with the general. They have machine guns. They fire. They are prepared against the scout snipers there of the Soviet Union or the USSR. Planes are still firing at each other. Stukas are dropping bombs. So this is a dirt road. So most of their infantry has routed. But as usual, the planes are the deciding factor of the battle. We have some infantry still standing here. Some of them have started to rout because the enemy planes are now above them. Our planes are not that many anymore. Seem to be very few in there. Most of the Stukas that can't really fight the MiG-3s. We have some Messerschmitt 109s in there too. They are more than a match, but unfortunately too few in the battle. If the enemy is going to start spamming planes, then I might actually come to regret having built a lot of panzers. So but I will still continue my panzer constructing until I feel they only focus on planes. Then I will change to planes. Here's some building, the farm. So 62% allies killed, 54% enemies killed, so they are leading now. Some troops have entered the farmland here. The infantry. Let's move the planes under AI control and the infantry. It's up to the AI now to try and change the battle here. outcome of the battle. So if we manage to defeat the Soviet Union in the east, then I will actually spawn their eastern armies by taking a look at the map and using a cheat code, so they will show up. When they have one area left, I will spawn them if I can to the east, so they will get their armies from the east to the east. So it will be more of a challenge, because the Soviet Union is cut in half due to the map, because there is no way to have the entire world be a united globe, unfortunately. So assault infantry, if we had had Soviet Union as one united country in the on the map, then Japan would be on one side and the United States on the other, and that would have been bad for their wars. So take a look at the general, is he being fired at? We have our general over here. Some bodyguards. He is at a safe distance away from the fighting in the air. The air battles. Statistics now. Allies kill 66%. Percentage enemies kill 54%. So we haven't managed to kill off any more of them. The battle is raging. Let's fast forward. I don't have time. Here we have someone moving some assault infantry. Let's move some riflemen back to the army there. Only two Stuka tactical bombers are left in the air. Only one. Let's move to the jeep again. So we have six Stuka tactical bombers in the air. Oops, shit, motherfuckers. Retreat, general, retreat. They're being fired at, they might die. There's the general, come on. Yes, he managed to survive, almost everyone died. These planes just showed up out of nowhere. And the statistics of the battle. 9% allies killed, 54% enemies. We didn't manage to kill any more of their planes. Our infantry are alone. And now they are defeated. They won. They had superiority in the air. So, Felix Battle. They had 786 men, killed 518, which is very good. Men remaining 107. Ivan Kudyakov died, and he had 848 men, killed 345, which is okay, and has 396 left. Captain Pyotr had 107 men, mostly planes, or only planes, killed 297, very good, and 73 planes left. Let's see the statistics, the details here. Hopefully it won't crash now. Sure, we want to go home, we want this war over with. The quickest way to get it over with is to go get the bastards who started it. The quicker they are whipped, the quicker we can go home. The shortest way home is through Berlin and Tokyo. And when we get to Berlin, I am personally going to shoot that paper hanging son of a bitch Hitler, just like if I'd shoot a snake. I believe that was General George S. Patton of the United States. Oh, we are attacked again. Another battle. they are attacking the army outside of Minsk. George Suko with 371 men. He is a two-star general. Right. He has three plane units, two MiG-3s and one Jak-9, one MS-1 tank, and he has the General Sergei Petrov here. The rifleman bodyguard sits a starting general, not a real general. He has Nikolai Ivanov with another rifleman bodyguard, also starting general, and of course Georgi Suko. It might have an actual armored officer car, yes. He's a real general. And let's save the game before playing the battle, so we don't have to replay both those battles if it's CTDs. So save succeeded, and let's jump straight into the battle. Before we're through with them, the Japanese language will be spoken only in Hell. Admiral Halsey, December 1941. So they are attacking. They are selling out. So this is their city. It's a German. I believe this is a German large town. No, it's a city. This is a German city. No, wait. There is. I believe there is a town, and then there's a large town. This is the large town. Then there's a city, and then there is a large city. I believe this is the large town. They are selling out to face our army. We have mostly infantry, that's why they can win. Our general will fight too. Put them in loose formation and AI control. And guard mode. Ah, this unit actually had two riders of the BMW motorcycles. So it was a fresh unit of BMW motorcycles there. Even had some rams. Let's drop those rams. You don't need them now. Let's just fire at will if you want to. Yeah. General has died. Sergei Petrov is dead already. Probably was in one of those infantry units close to our army. So this is a German large town, but all of the settlements are German currently. Degwax has created Italian settlements, but it's not finished with them. I don't have them yet, and I didn't want to, you know, get them and mess up my campaign. I only want them if we can implement them and the campaign is still playable, but I don't think it will be if we add them. So, because I don't want to replay anything, I want to finish this campaign. But yeah, he has probably only one settlement left, I think, and the capital. So like the large city and the capital, maybe. And for Germany, he has the Berlin capital left. They are supposed to sell you out. I don't know why they haven't done so. Some of their planes have moved out. The rams are pretty cool. Jeeps. So the Stokes mortar can attack their their bunkers. I think. What happened with my BMW motorcycle? It's already out. No, it's the bodyguard. I have a bodyguard of BMW motorcycles. That's cool. I've never seen a bodyguard with BMWs before. Here's the general. So we are firing at their bunkers now. With the Stokes mortars. We are getting hit there. They sent out some of their planes. Yak 9 fighters. Alright, so the German army is moving back while the planes are still continuing to fight. We'll deselect the AI control. Stop your actions. And then we will manually select them to attack the planes. Attack these planes. Here we have another MiG-3s. Then we have some more planes here. So let's just attack them. We had 2 units of Stukas, that's not good. The Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes reached this unit. The others went for the other planes. They might lose actually, because they are bombers. They are dropping bombs all over the place here. Terrorizing their troops on the ground. Good attack. Already. Not the general. I ordered the infantry to just rush the city now. Alright, so the German infantry is finally recharging the city. Actually, the general could be good if they took out some of their staff. Stukas could take care of their jeeps actually on the ground. Ah, we have taken the center we had for a while. A few seconds, yeah. Infantry has reached the outskirts of the city. They are already routed because of their planes there. They're being fired from the air. I see. The planes seem to be losing the battle. Let's pause the game. Need to take down those planes. Get my Messerschmitts, or the battle is lost. My general fallen. Jorge Shrukov is dead. He took out their general. The center was taken. The airplanes are fighting the airplanes. So we haven't won in the air. We need to win in the air to take the city. Let's move our general back. Let's also place the mortars on the fired wheel. Actually, they will not fire at wheel. I could see them firing at the planes. You need them to take out the planes. Otherwise, we can't win this battle. Their planes easily took out our infantry. Battle at the center still going on here in the sky. MiG-3s versus Messerschmitt 109s. The infantry crushed. Best infantry there. Because planes are not to be messed with. Our Stokes mortars are still firing at their planes now. Took out their bunkers too. So this is the Battle of Minsk. It's nice to be on the offensive at least. I'm surprised we had a BMW motorcycle bodyguard. The first one I saw in this campaign. We have some troops this far in. They reach this far. They were killed there. Planes are still firing. Fighting there. They took down the Stuka there. Place them on AI and just click there. Take the center. Building captured, building lost, building captured, etc. etc. Yeah. The infantry was slaughtered on the outskirts of the city due to the planes. Our planes weren't many. We didn't have enough planes to take out theirs. Still think they have the advantage in the air. Maybe we can still win. We have the better planes after all, the better quality, higher quality planes. I like this town or city or whatever. I believe it's a town, a large town, because it has like civilian cars and stuff, very detailed. Degovex did a great job on it. With an SS infantry unit has reached the city and is soon to enter the plaza, I believe. They will probably be easily destroyed by their planes when they do. How many are they? 11. Maybe we can win by taking the center and holding it for a while. No, they routed. They were shot at by the planes. They had infantry over there as well. Firing at them. We can destroy buildings, but only with artillery, and we only had Stokes mortars, and only two of them. Not enough to destroy entire cities. tanks and planes can't destroy buildings because they aren't artillery, they are cavalry. That's sad, but we need more artillery so we can destroy the cities. That's a luxury we could afford only when we have reached a certain point in the campaign. Because artillery is easily defeated, we can't waste recruitment on them this early in the campaign. Alright, allies kill 75%, enemies kill 70%. So they are winning the battle, but it's very equal in terms of percentage killed. So the Stokes mortars are continuing to fire their shells at the city. The battle inside of the city, they are still holding the center. Seem to have won the air battle. We still have a Stuka tactical bomber in the air, but it can't win against all the remaining fighters they have. As far as I can see, 5 or 6 fighters. Yeah, we have lost all our fighters. So they have won the battle in the air, and therefore they have won this battle. I mean, this Stuka will soon be shot down from the sky. Then we only have this Stokes mortars over here. They're continuing to fire. Actually, just shoot at anything. I don't care if you die. Destroy as much as you can of the city. Alright, so they will send out their planes against the Stokes mortars soon. They already had started to do it, I believe. So the general will now start to retreat. Our bodyguard here, BMW motorcycle bodyguard. Don't know exactly where the general is, but should be somewhere. There he is. So, BMW motorcycle, tank, cavalry, so they are counted as tanks, shooting their machine gun at the enemy. And there they left the battlefield. So we still have the Stokes mortars firing. They are doomed. See here, 76% allies killed, 74% enemies killed. So a very equal battle. But we have clearly lost according to the meter there. It's that balance of power meter. Wonder if they can't fire anymore. And it's time to retreat. These are still firing. Now they can't fire anymore. Retreat. And our assault infantry is already reaching the border. Fast forward. I wonder why they aren't hunting me down with the planes. So this infantry unit is leaving the battlefield. The other one behind there. Stokes mortar artillery. Last unit left the battle. Let's pause. Just want to take a look at the actual city. We killed a lot of our troops, our infantry, before they even started to march. But they were just shot down where they stood. That's because the planes they sent out has a very long range. Then we took out their bunkers. I thought we did, maybe not. Maybe they didn't take out their bunkers. Took out some of their planes. They took out some of ours. A lot of our infantry were killed. Some planes were killed here as well. Inside of the city. A lot of infantry were killed here. Planes. Jeeps. I think we took out their jeep bodyguard. So their cities, did we take out any buildings? I don't think so. They might have fired at the planes instead. So we killed slightly more in person than they did. I mean, they killed slightly more. Clear defeat! Gunther Alterbung's army were destroyed. Men deployed 597 men. He himself managed to flee. Killed 274, so he killed about half of what he had. Men remaining 131. Georgios Suko died. He had 371 men. He killed 456. That's very good, thanks to mostly having planes. And he has 131 left. So we have the same amount of soldiers left, but they had planes, and we had Stokes mortars and a jeep bodyguard, a BMW motorcycle bodyguard. Here's the detailed stats decks. Let's hope it won't crash. This was a siege battle. It might crash. The enemy knows that he must wipe out our fighters. Once he has done that, he will be able to play football with the German people. Field Marshal Erhard Milch, 1943. Yeah, it didn't crash. War declared on ally by Hungary on Bulgaria. I won't take Hungary's side. Bulgaria has been loyal to us. Alright, end of turn report. Good, we are not minus anymore. Construction report. In Frankfurt we have a large caserne. And in Rouen we have a medium caserne. And in Amsterdam we have a large caserne, and in Brussels we have a mortar training ground. Nice. Recruitment report. In Berlin we have a new Panzer IV. In Frankfurt we have a Panzer IV. In Vienna we have an assault infantry unit. In München we have a Panzer IV. In Flamberg we have a Panzer I. Copenhagen assault infantry. Oslo assault infantry. Rouen Panzer I. Amsterdam Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Paris Stuka tactical bombers. Brussels we have a Panzer I. Prague we have a Panzer IV. Bordeaux a Panzer I. Warsaw a Panzer I. Stettin a Panzer IV. Alright. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. Hungary and Bulgaria. Hungary declared war on Bulgaria. Two Axis powers. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. Turkey has declared peace with Romania. and Hungary has declared peace with the British Commonwealth of Nations. Alliance and Tatars, Hungary and the Third Reich, because we didn't join Hungary in their war against Bulgaria. Also, we can see that the Turkish army is outside of Odessa, so they are marching all the way here. Family member, they have an armored officer's car as a bodyguard, pretty good bodyguard. And they have cavalry unit here. They also have some engineer infantry. Can't see their other units, but they have a full army there. They have two armies. Romania has planes. They have Messerschmitt 109 planes, the same as ours, so they are good. Then they have some Sommer S-35 tanks. The best French tanks from the war. They had a futuristic tank in the game as well that was never built, but this is the best that was actually built. So Romania has some French tanks. Some infantry there, and a stronger arm here with mostly infantry. So we have a retreated arm here. I just merged the infantry units. They are allied. We support them, that means war against Turkey, and I don't want war against Turkey, but at the same time, Turkey has gone too far. But I won't care about that. We will move the units towards the German border. Or the Polish border, actually, held by the Germans. So we have an army here. This army will take up the mantle of the fallen army and besiege Brest, or Minsk, I mean. He will besiege Minsk. We have a Stokes mortar, but I want to at least actually we could attack if we have a Stokes mortar. Alright, so we could attack immediately. We will attack this time. The AI will control this army with the general, and we will control the other general. We might lose the general, of course. That doesn't matter. He had mostly planes, yes. So, Erwin Rommel could either march towards this army, or he could march towards Leningrad. And I think he'll march towards the army. Because his army is not made for siege battles. I prefer to use infantry armies for that role, because the bunkers can't really kill all of the infantry before they enter the city, but their tanks and such, they will easily be destroyed by the bunkers. However, we need to take out planes with heavier stuff like planes and tanks. So this army has a lot of planes, which is good. Erwin Rommel only had a few. He couldn't attack this turn. So they have beaten us back from Kiev. And Felix Battle has survived and is moving towards Brest. We have Walter Graf here, he was also defeated. In Brest we have a new army. So all of these could be moved there. Towards Brest. Including the general, because he hasn't been defeated yet. So I have a higher hope for him. He won't be defeated the first thing that happens. Let's send some infantry back to Warsaw. And yes, we could send some infantry to Warsaw. Send this general to Warsaw. The tank unit to Brest. So a pretty good force here. Like the infantry be replaced, maybe keep one unit of snipers, but the other three can't be counted. We need to send this army towards Brest. So we have 4 units. We will leave 3 units of riflemen there, send one of the other riflemen to Brest as well. And let's move these units out actually. Very good force there. The general. So we have 3 units of BMW motorcycles and we have 4 units of Stuka tactical bombers, 1 unit of Messerschmitt 109 fighters. We didn't have a lot of fighters, but we have 6 units of Panzer 1s here, and we have 5 units of Panzer 4s. So it's a pretty strong force, this one. I'd like, however, to have a infantry unit as well. So we need to remove something. We will remove 1 BMW motorcycle unit and move in a unit of snipers. Alright, that's a full army. Ready to march. Remove these to Brest. We only have 1 army here, plus this remnant that we will use when we attack. Erwin Rommel can't do anything for now. Warsaw, we can move these units to Warsaw. Vienna there. Panzer Force, let's move it to Warsaw. Another Panzer IV. And in Berlin, another one. And the Stokes Mortar, let's move it there too. In Hamburg, Panzer I, of course, we will move it too. Towards the front. We don't need tanks in any other area. USSR diplomat outside of München. We'll move the Panzer IV towards Warsaw. Let's move it into Stettin. No, we move it there outside of Stettin. Frankfurt, we all have another one. Let's move it too. Amsterdam, we don't have anyone there. And in München, we've already checked that. Stokes Mortar, let's move it towards Prague. And the BMW motorcycle could be moved towards Stettin. Bristol, we have another Panzer I. Of course, we'll move it too. We can check Rouen, we now have a Panzer I built and ready. In Paris we have another Stuka tactical bomber that we can now move. And in Bordeaux we have a Panzer I. Alright. And that's it. Now it's the ships again. Portugal, we don't need to speak to them. So move towards Africa, I want a diplomat in Africa. So we can speak with other allies and get their map information. So let's take a look at the recruitment and construction. Start with the construction. Frankfurt, we can build SS headquarters. They only enable the recruitment of spies here and or an aerodrome. Let's start with the SS headquarters then. Amsterdam. Well, let's go for a mortar training ground. And Rowan, we will go for a mortar training ground as well. And that's it. Recruitment. Let's go back to Berlin. Alright, so we will continue our massing of tanks. So Panzer 4s and Panzer 1s. And some assault infantry in Oslo. We get Panzer 4 in München. Panzer 4 in Frankfurt. Could get a Messerschmitt 109 fighter in Amsterdam and a Panzer 1 in Brussels, Stuka tactical bomber in Paris, Panzer 1 in Rouen, Panzer 1 in Bordeaux, and a Panzer 1 in Warsaw. Assault infantry unit in Vienna, and Panzer 4 in Prague, Panzer 4 in Stettin as well, then assault infantry in Copenhagen. We're back in Berlin. Now it's the agents. We moved one agent, one diplomat onto the ships. Have some ships here that I want to send to take care of that Soviet fleet. Speak with Soviets again, see if they have anything new on the map.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
So we have an updated map. So the Soviet Union have gone down here. Baku, they might have had it from the start, or it was a Turkish city. Turkey is very strong. They have taken some areas and gone up there. Fortunately, I didn't have to join the war with my ally there. So the diplomat in Spain is on the ships there, towards that are heading for Africa. We have another diplomat over here. I'm not exactly sure where it is, but there, Hungary. Let's speak to them again.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Map information, map information.
Balanced or very generous treaty.
Alliance, military access, military access. So we're allied again with Hungary. So they are at a ceasefire again. So Bulgaria and Romania. Alright, let's see if there are any battles we need to fight. I believe there is one. We will win easily, I guess. Let's say before the battle in case it will crash. It's a siege battle after all. No, this time it will probably, yeah, yes. Fight a battle on the battle map. We are now in this war, we are all in it, all the way. Franklin D. Roosevelt, 9th December 1941. Wait, start deployment, it's winter time. It's the first time there is winter in this game, in this campaign. The reason is because winter is only like a third or something of the year. We are playing with 24 turns per year, and winter is only a third or something. Originally I spoke with Degvax about having winter half the time, but it wasn't a good idea because there were some reason for it that it wasn't a good idea. So that's why winter is kind of rare. Yes, we are attacking the Soviet Union during winter. That's perfect. It brings some reality to the war. So we have reached winter 1942. We are at the end of the year, probably. All right. So we will. I think we will place the general far away, and then we will move the infantry very close so they can easily enter the city. Then these units, the mortars, will fire too.